guys, welcome to today's vlog. So I just wrapped up with filming for my main channel. I've just done next week's video. It was a hard one to film. You guys will see what I mean once it actually goes up, but it was very personal and quite raw and something that I've really felt I needed to film for a while. But then I thought it would just be a nice opportunity to vlog because it's kind of like I need to shake it off, and I wanted to show you guys my tea collection today because one, I need a cup of tea, and two, I got a lot of requests to share more about the tea that I have, as well as all of my teacups, mugs, and all of my little teapots that I brew my tea in. So I don't know why I had to say that I brew my tea in. Obviously, they're teapots. But I wanted to show you my tea collection. I've actually tidied up the kitchen this morning, so it's looking good. It's okay to bring visitors into the apartment and show you guys around. So I'm gonna take you guys into the kitchen and, yeah, show you my tea collection. And it is growing, and I mean rapidly growing right now. So let me take you through all of the tea, and then I wanna take you through my teacups and mugs because, oh, I'm so excited. I've just organized the cupboard and they look pretty good. Okay, first off, tea time. So, what's my favorite one? At the moment, my favorite tea is the rooibos with vanilla flavor. It's from Narada, and I originally found it when I was in Byron on a yoga retreat. So I love Byron Bay, and they always get me into some good habits. So I usually brew this one with a little bit of rice milk. It just makes it a bit more creamy, and also I don't really do so well with dairy, so that's why I use rice milk. Then this one is something that I've gotten recently from a health food store. It is a turmeric latte blend. And what's in this one? Yeah, it's got turmeric, cinnamon, Ceylon, ginger, nutmeg, cardamom, black pepper, and saffron. And it's a really nice one. I've only used it a few times, but it's really nice. I just brew it in a little saucepan. This guy is obviously an oldie but a goodie. I love the cocoa and chai spice from Henry Langdon. Definitely one of my faves still. This is our engagement tea. So one of my beautiful friends, Sarah, has a tea business, a high tea business, and her tea brand is called Impala and Peacock. And she actually brewed Adam and I our very own signature tea blend for our engagement party. And it's a really nice loose leaf blend. I'll show you guys what's inside. So the tea that we had made is a blend of lavender, lemon verbena, and lemon balm. It is so beautiful, so light and delicate, and I think I'm actually down to my last packet to my dismay, but maybe she can make me a few more because it's really beautiful. Then in this canister we have some more tea, or I have some more tea because Adam doesn't really drink that much tea, it's more just me. But these are some more of the little sachets from my friend Sarah's tea house. So this one's called Mint Variation, which I actually had 2 mornings ago because I ran out of lemon. Usually I just do hot water and lemon first thing in the morning. So there's a few others. This was the first little one that she made us for our engagement. That was a little tester. And there's a few other teas my sister gave me from T2 in here, but I don't really use them. So they're kind of just sitting there. Then I've got a little display here of some of my favorites that I use quite regularly. So I've got the Puka, or I think it's Puka tea. The Relax is quite nice. There's the Sleepy Me, which I haven't used in a while. White tea is really only for guests, just because I feel like I want to make sure I've got white tea and black tea for people. And chamomile, and I think that one is, I'm pretty sure it's a green tea, could be a mint. But I do have a really nice green tea here because my sister loves green tea, so that's actually for her. And then I think I've spoken to you guys about my love for chai. So this one is Chai Wali caffeine free. It's got beautiful rose petals and it is amazing. And it's really funny, so my best friend Lance, she also loves tea. And so whenever she comes over, I have to have tea brewing and ready for her because it's freezing in Melbourne. So I usually make this one and it's, I think, both of our favorites at the moment. And I add a little bit of rice milk and also some honey. And of course, I've told you guys about my mum's little beehive. So they make us some honey with their love and generosity. And I try and have not too much, but I think like a teaspoon a day of raw organic honey is totally fine. Alright, now onto my tea collection because I can't wait. It looks so nice. I actually spent a while tidying the pantry yesterday and also the cupboards. So check this out, guys. Did someone say tea time? Oh, yes, please. So these are my favorite mugs, but I actually have more mugs on the top shelf up there, but I don't really use them that much. And I feel like I need to stand on a chair to show you all of these. But here are some of my favorites. I'm gonna go through them shortly. And here are my little kettles and teapots. And yeah, my collection is ever growing very rapidly. I need to kind of slow down on adding to it because I have no room. That's better. Okay, I'm standing on a chair, so I better be careful. But I want to take you through some of my favorites. So this one's from Kiki Kane. It says, "There's always time for tea." That was actually a cute little gift from my mum. This one is a gift from my sister, which said she believed she could, so she did. And when the High School Survival Guide, My Study Skills book, came out in bookstores, my sister got me that mug, so that's a very special one for me. These two beautiful blue ones with the gold handles, they were presents for our engagement party, and I love them. They're from T2. And then Lan's got me this one when she did a market recently. And it's handmade mosaic. It's got a beautiful green, like a mint green interior. I love it because it's like a little hug mug. And then what else do I have in here? I've got a really cool white one, which I've had for a while. That white one back there was like $6 from Kmart. So you just never know where you're gonna find a good one to add to the collection, guys. You've got to be open-minded. And this one was another gift from my sister. I don't think it was for any reason in particular. She just saw it had a bunny and thought of me. And then the gray and white hug mugs over here are also pretty cool. They're from a brand called Robert Gordon, and actually this blue one over here is a recent addition. So I picked this guy up from Freedom Furniture, and I've actually got two matching soup bowls, which are really cute. And I think the black one was also a gift from Adam and my engagement from my friend Sarah. All right, so let's have a look at what's on the next shelf. So this one is probably one of my favorites. It was a gift from my best friend Zara and her husband, and that's also from T2. This one is also from Robert Gordon, I think, and I bought that a little while ago. I've got a few other glass ones just behind over here as well. And that one was from Adam years ago, actually. I'm really surprised it's lasted us well and I haven't dropped or chipped it, which is good. It's got a little tea light stand so you can actually keep the tea warm, which I really like. Then the little black one's just good for brewing like one cup of tea if you want to make like honey, lemon and ginger. And the pink one is probably my favorite one right now. It's perfect to use if I've got a friend over because it does make two cups of tea. So that is my tea collection, my teacup, my pots, my tea, everything. Now you guys know my obsession is real and it's rapidly growing. So I feel like I really need to tell people we don't have room for more tea, but I love tea. I feel like it's so calming. It's the best way to just relax and unwind. And yeah, I love to start my day with a cup of tea. I love to just have a tea whenever I'm working. You should ask Adam. Like honestly, every time I sit down at my desk, I am having a cup of tea because not that I'm stressed when I work, I just find it really nice and relaxing. And I don't know, whenever I edit my videos, I've always got a cup of tea there. It's just habit, I guess. So guys, comment down below, what is your favorite tea at the moment? I go through phases. It used to be chamomile for a long time just because it's really calming and relaxing. And then I really liked green tea, black tea. Now it's rooibos. And I know it's a really particular kind of taste. My mum doesn't like it. When I first tried it, I thought it was disgusting. But the one with the vanilla extract in it is so nice. If you guys have tried it, please comment down below. And if there's any tea that I should probably add to my collection, I don't know what, because I feel like I have everything, but maybe I don't. If there's any tea brands, any tea that you recommend, please let me know as well, because I'm always totally open to those kind of suggestions. Any excuse to keep buying tea. I mean, honestly, it's life. Tea is life. There's always time for tea, as the teacup says. Anyway, I'm gonna end this vlog here. I know it was really short, but I just felt like doing a tiny vlog today, especially because I was filming a bit of a heavier video for my main channel, and I'm gonna try and do some more vlogs later this week. I'm gonna try and post up a couple times a week and just like see how I go, but I wanna make sure that I'm posting up some like fun stuff, some challenges with my sister or friends, and I also need to be doing some more cooking and book reviews because I love filming that stuff, so keep an eye out. But don't forget to subscribe if you guys are new to my vlog channel, because I feel like this baby is pretty new. Even though I started it a few years ago, I haven't really posted until quite recently. So I hope you guys are liking my vlogs, and I'm gonna make a cup of tea. Can you guess which one I'm making? I think you can. Bye.